Take me back to the first season when that conversation started happening about the intimacy coordinator and how it came up and where you were coming from and what it felt like that to bring that to the table.
Yeah. So for me, you know, during season one already, I've, you know, been acting since I was 16. I've been doing sex scenes since I was 16. I've had, you know, long evolution of my relationship with that. And doing it so regularly, doing it meaning sexual content on a show, that was for the first time probably what I thought it was the most important story about sex that I was telling. So it was never that I didn't want to use sex in the story. But
it was never like, they like each other, so now we need a sex scene.
Much more the show is about this. Yes, and it never was for not for me, but as somebody who was getting older and more honest with myself and my sensitivity and what kind of life I wanted to live and what kind of personal sexuality I wanted to have, I was finding myself, you know, sort of like Pinocchio becoming a real boy, like transforming into this creature who felt feelings, and I didn't know what to do with them, and I'd kind of gotten myself in this situation in this career where it was hard to let those both exist, to both be sensitive and present in your sexuality, but also have to kind of put on armor and a brave face at work to tell the story. And so that happened, and I was already feeling those feelings at the end of season one, and then in going into season two, everything with Time's Up and Me Too exploded, and as we all know, we were having these huge conversations about sex in the workplace, and for me, I did a lot of self-reflecting and asking myself how I had perpetuated those issues by either witnessing or participating or staying silent, and to me, I didn't know that intimacy coordinators were a position. They were, but I didn't know that. But I sort of on my own thought that what would make me feel more comfortable would be to have somebody who's there on set, who their main job is to help oversee and facilitate and just be there for sex scenes, like a stunt coordinator, like an animal handler, like a child chaperone, to help with extra sensitive things. So I went to the producers and to HBO and I asked for this, and it turned out that it already existed. It just wasn't being used in film and television yet, and they hired one for our show, and then HBO wound up hiring it for all the shows, and so it goes.